Mibei. Agwambo. Baba. Nelson Mandela Jr. Honorable Raila Amolo Odinga. Baba again.
Supported by members of parliament and members of county assembly You must know that there's something seriously wrong with Project Red. Something much bigger. The issue we're dealing with in Kenya today is much bigger than just a rigged election. It is how we want to live in this geographical space called Kenya.
Yes.
In America, on the causes of the American Revolution, they are being taxed by the crown, but there's no representation. That's why they said no taxation,
no representation.
This is what it was. And that is how America fought and got independent from Britain.
And we will.
So where we are here is that you are in a situation where you are being ruled without having a say on it.
Yeah.
You don't need to have a say. You are being taxed.
You pay tax.
And that tax on yours is misappropriated. And you have no recourse.
Yes. No rule of law.
You're being monies are borrowed on your behalf. That money is misappropriated. In the end, you are forced to repay that loan.
Yes.
So many things are wrong with the Project Kenya today. Today they have admitted finally that Kenya is bankrupt.
Broke.
No, it's not bankrupt. You are not able to repay your debts. You're not able to repay your debts. That is where we are. We're now teetering on the brink of becoming a basket economy. Because of mismanagement of our economy. And this is why we want to look at a long-term solution, how to solve this problem. How to solve this problem. And this is an issue that requires bigger discourse and bigger debate.
Yes,
as Kenyans.
Yes.
Elections, you know, we went to elections and we told our people that this time round, if they try to steal, we will not come back and cry that they have stolen the election. We will deal with them squarely. To say this is the same, what is bigger? What is sabu? What is jumulisha? What is rusha? What is tangaza? What is riba? Because we said that we knew that they were going to try to attempt to rig the elections. There's no way that the Jubilee can defeat NASA. There's no way that the Jubilee can defeat NASA in terms of popular vote. Because NASA's support base is much bigger than that of Jubilee. And they know it. And they know it. They can only try to rig. Can only rig. But this time around, you put all the traps. You know, first when we said we're going to have our own parallel turning center, they said this is illegal.
Yeah.
But you said no, there's nothing illegal about parallel turning center. It is done all over the world. And eventually, the Electoral Commission agreed we could have our own turning center. 3 days to the polling, they invaded our tallying center.
Yes.
They sent a team of goons, hooded like Al-Shabaab, But Al-Qaeda.
Yeah.
Terrorists. They invaded our training center, beat up security officers, vandalized the place, took all computers, and took off. Our investigation immediately showed that five of them were serving officers at the Parkland police station. They were telling us, report to the police. We got a report to the police station, and five of those officers came from that same police station. So as far as they are concerned, we were now crippled. They didn't know that we had another contingent arrangement with another terrorist center. We even had a terrorist center in the clouds. So to them now, they did not know that we were recording.
Yeah, on iCloud.
So then, when we said we were not going to court, they now looked at organizations which they thought would go to court. They were now hitting at those organizations. We were very busy compiling all that evidence, putting it together. When we were ready, then we told Orengo, turn him a command. So, Leona. Then all our lawyers worked. Orengo put together a team of 25 lawyers. Some of them were very young lawyers. Very brilliant.
Including women.
Very brilliant, yeah. Quite a number of them were women. So this team gathered all the evidence. Then wakasema gari tosha gari. So we went to court. Then when we went to court, they were surprised. You saw Otinda Mon.
Yeah.
You saw Rengo.
Yes.
You saw Paul Mwangi.
Yes.
You saw Mutaka Kangu.
Yes.
You saw Kongo Mogeni. So Feroz Nori.
Yes.
See you. Mawakili wa NASA. The other side you saw Wanangatia. The other one there at the Paul Mwiti. The other one I hit was here at Abdi Kadir, somebody. The other one Fiyo Lumumba. Taka taka yote. Said that these elections were not held in accordance with the constitution and the laws of Kenya.
That's right.
And therefore directed the electoral commission, the chairman, to deal with irregularities and illegalities before they can hold another election. We told them, these are the 12 points you need to address for their election to be free and fair. And then we saw that we were not going to address them. Each time we meet, they refuse to address. So we realized we were going to go back for a repeat of what we had been through. And then we said, no, we cannot do the same thing the same way and expect a different result. We said, no, not yet. That's why we pulled out of those elections.
We told you pull out, we told you boycott.
Yes. And we said, there will be no elections. We said, there will be no elections. So we told our supporters, stay at home. Don't go out of your homes and pray. And our supporters heeded our call. Stay at home. There were no people going out there to vote. Jubilee itself was embarrassed.
No trendy of numbers.
even the so-called children of numbers. Because here, Lord Uhuru running against Kenyatta. And then, when I want to beat Kenyatta, then you know, I'm suddenly running against the turnout. The turnout was too embarrassing low. Less than 30% of the people who reached the voters turned up to vote. So this is the dilemma that he found himself in. But now, where we are, the issue is now, because now we have a situation where the so-called president has no legitimacy, does not enjoy support of three-quarters of the country. So this is what needs to be fixed. That the issue of elections is supposed to produce leadership. But it cannot be that you have a situation where the people turn out in large numbers to go and vote. In the morning, mothers, old men, children are lining up long queues. It is raining on them. The sunshine. And then once they finish, it is not how they voted at the polling station that is tallied at the national tallying center. That is not even ball game. A completely different result are announced at the national polling tallying center. That cannot be an election.
No.
Cannot be an election. We are seeing a trend which is actually prevalent in other African countries, where the incumbents hold elections as rituals.
Right.
Elections as rituals which must be won by the incumbent at all costs.
Yes, that's right.
Rigging of elections. Where they waste 40 billion shillings of taxpayers' money.
Yes.
During an election, when you're ready, you already have predetermined the outcome.
Right.
And what we're talking about is not the only presidential elections. Gubernatorial, eight governors are not genuinely elected. Those were won by NASA governors, but they were rigged the way they rigged the presidency. The same thing with senators and a number of members of parliament. So that Jubilee is enjoying an artificial majority in parliament, in the Senate, and also in the governors. So now, this is what we now want to repeat. Project Kenya. That we must have a Kenya that we want.
Yes.
Kenyans must have the leadership that they deserve, that they desire. Yes. Kenyans don't want computers to elect for them leaders. Vifaranga vya computer. Wananchi wanatoa vifaranga vya kuku, ifike Nairobi inabadilisha na kuwa vifaranga vya computer. That is what we say we don't want to see happen. And that's why we say we must have a discourse as Kenyans. We must put back Project Kenya on the table.
Yes.
And discuss this matter properly.
Yes.
That's why we say People's Assembly.
Yes.
People's Assembly. The motion is already out. It has already been passed by the County Assembly of Shire,
Vihiga,
Kakamega, Kisumu, and so on and so forth. So it's going to be passed. This is unstoppable. This process is unstoppable.
Yes.
It will move. I catch and it will take on its own life, like a bushfire.
Yes.
You have said you want to put on the table the issues of first electoral commission. This animal. What kind of electoral commission do you want to have as Kenyans? One. Number two, how do we secure the independence of the judiciary? The judiciary is not threatened by the executive. The president comes up and says, oh, Wakora. Wakora. Wameibu shindi wangu. Mapinduzi ya mahakama. I shall deal with them when I get back. Said before Uhuru goes to deal with Maraga, Kenya are going to deal with him.
Yes!
So he said, this is must be on the tip. The other one is the issue of structure of executive.
Yes.
The structure of executive must be revisited. The original Bomas draft constitution, which was trashed by the executive at that time, the Kibaki, must come back on the table for discussion. When we had a hybrid system of government, with a president and with a prime minister, we must bring that draft on the table. Thirdly, the issue of devolution. Devolution was also trashed last time because they did not want devolution. That's why they decided to come up with small units. Kenya has got 47 counties and their governors. Almost as many as the United States. Yet Kenya itself is just the size of Texas. South Africa has got 10 provinces. Mozambique has got 11 provinces. Nigeria, with 155 million people, has got 36 states. With 155 million people, and the size of the Nigeria is more than double the size of Kenya. So we need to revisit the devolution as was passed in Bomas of Kenya.
Yes, yes.
This is issues which are bringing to the table right now. And then we'll deal with all this, and this will deal with it very quickly. People's Assembly will pass resolutions. When they will pass the resolutions, we'll put them together, and then we'll go for an election. That election is also going to be a referendum on the new constitutional structure.
Yes.
That's it. So this time around, it is a people power. What has happened here is a tragedy. You see how children are being killed. Children are being killed. They shoot a young girl in a plane on top of a balcony. They shoot a child, as I just mentioned to you here. The other day, there was a small girl, 2 years old, with a bullet lodged around her neck. You see, a woman with a bullet lodged here on her thigh. This kind of injuries that I have to deal with almost on a daily basis, and they're terrible. The crime is that these people are exercising their constitutional right to demonstrate.
Yes.
So we have a regime that has become rogue. A rogue regime.
Thank you.
So you say, paka imekuwa paka mwitu. Paka imekuwa paka mwitu. Wajaluo nasema ni paka lokrogwa. Yawawa.
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 Unaweza kuchukua kamba, uweke hapa, uweke pale ukanyonge. Uweke kuweka kisu au ukachukua gunia ndani ya gunia, alafu unaenda kwa maji tupa huko ndani. Sawa?
Ndio.
Kwa hiyo sasa tunasema tutatumia mbinu tofauti. We will use all the other avenues that are available to us.
By any means necessary.
We said Demonstration is just one option. But we have also other options, picketing, striking,
boycott.
We will select only companies which are benefiting the Jubilee government. Safaricom has been chosen because Safaricom is complicit in manipulation of election results. And we have clear evidence of that. That is the reason why Safaricom has been chosen. So saying, oh, jobs are going to be lost. No, jobs are not going to be lost, jobs are being transferred. Diaspora Tilana.
Diaspora
Tilana.
Diaspora
Tilana. As I did, sir.